son of Pethuel. Hear this, ye old men, and give ear, all ye inhabitants of the land. Have this been in your days, or even in the days of your fathers? Tell ye your children of it, and let your children tell their children, and their children another generation. That which the palm worm hath left, hath the locust eaten. And that which the locust had left, hath the cankerworm eaten. And that which the cankerworm had left, has the caterpillar eaten. Can you skip down with me to verse number 13? Are you with me? And he reads, gird yourselves and lament, ye priests, howl, ye ministers of the altar.
My definition of a father, originator, source, provider, protector, the number one person responsible for shaping the minds of his children.
Well, my definition of a father is basically a leader, someone who can see the future, someone that can see tomorrow before tomorrow even come. Someone can see their children years from now, not as they are toddlers.
Right.
That's the definition of a father.
My definition of a father is that fatherhood should start off from day one, being independent of any outside influences on the family.
Right.
You have to have fatherhood has to first connect with motherhood.
Right.
And motherhood and fatherhood coming together becomes familyhood.
I'm originally from Plainfield, New Jersey. I did have a father, but he wasn't in my life. I knew who he was. He died, though, when I was 19 years old. And prior to him dying, I probably spent 2 summers with my father.
Wow.
I can remember going to stay with him for 2 summers. That was it.
All right, my definition of a father is, I guess being a real man, you know, being there for your children when they need you. Good times, bad times, everything is not going to be good, you know, but it's a part of life. And I thank God that I'm a good father, because there's some of us out there who don't even know what their kids look like.
Exactly.
He's out there saying, man, look, I pay $600 a week. I don't got to get visitation.
Right.
You know, and it's their mindsets like that. So what would you like to say to some of the young guys out there, young dads?
What I would say to some of the young guys that's concerned about where their money is going. And I give my child support every month, and I think the mother is taking the money, and you know, or they just giving the money and they just think that that's it. I would say that the time you spend with your son or your daughter is more precious, more valuable than any dollar sign or any cent sign can replace. You can't replace the time that you'll spend, you know, with your kids.
Please be there, you know what I'm saying, be there for them in that family.
That's right.
So, you know, it's like, you know, with my daughter, man.
Yeah, he's
trying to tune it out, you know? Shit bother me every day. So, all right. It's like upon itself. Just what we're doing in my life.
My definition of a father is to be able to raise a child with informative information that will cause an everlasting change in a child's life, not only natural but in the spiritual realm also. A child has to be designed that they be able to succeed. We have to know that we cannot succeed without Christ in our life. So I think a father's job is definitely to impart religious, not only religious but informative gospel, the good message of Christ, meaning that God, he was born, raised, and he died for us, that we may be able to conquer whatever it is that comes our way. So I would say a good father is a God-fearing man.
Okay. Well, thank you for your time, man. I appreciate it, bro.
All righty. No All problem, right. brother.
God bless.
You're standing there smirking and bringing
all this grief on me. I never thought I could feel this way about my own child. But I hate you. Sometimes I wish she was never born. Only your father was here.
What if he was? He'd be a whine on the gutter.
Well, my definition of a father, first of all, is being out here in the world to be able to be a father. You know, me, myself, you know, I have been in the penal system over the last 12 years, in and out.
Wow.
So basically, dealing with my child, I have been dealing with my kids through the penal system.
Wow.
A lot of my kids, you know, I got 3 sons, and, you know, I'm telling my kids this and to do this and to become this and to become that, but the whole time watching their father be something totally different than what he's telling them to be.
Action.
My definition of a father is a provider.
My definition of a father is a leader.
Our definition of a father is our father.
Iron clothes for tomorrow, man. And his kids ready.
You on everybody's shirt?
They're in the uniforms.
Uniform?
Yeah.
Isn't this a mother's thing, man? Mother's job?
No. Sometimes.
But you prefer to do it?
No. Heck no. I'm just trying to make a job easier in the morning for her so she ain't got to do it in the morning.
That's what it is, man.
I leave out too early. I'll be gone. She getting ready for school in the morning.
You know, they just, it's a way out. You know, that the stepdad is like the way out. But in my situation, I became cool with my son's father. You know, I allow him to call. I allow him to come to my house. You know, when he graduated, I allowed him to come sit at my table. You know, I've done that because society wanted us to bicker with the biological father.
Right.
And I took the other way around it, you know. And even though, you know, I mean, I know my son loved me to death, you know, so I think I did a wonderful job.
Okay. Well, I think
he's out of order, because if my children's mother calls me, we can have conversations about our children together. It had nothing to do with my new wife.
Okay.
I'm not insecure.
He doesn't contact them or us or whatever. He contacts us on a sneak tip because she has a problem with it. But yet, so she has a son that's not his son, but he's supposed to interact with that child like it's okay.
Okay, and that's the discussion that we really need to be having within our culture, because that happens with all ethnicities within our culture, which is different from ethnicity, and especially amongst the culture of the 70s and the 60s, because I'm finding now that persons that came up in the 80s and the 90s, they don't carry it like that.
Mm-hmm.
Everyone gets along.
Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm.
My father is a protector, and being a protector, you always take, you know, you're always protecting your seed, protecting the space so that your child can be safe. And a lot of men, believe it or not, get that confused.
Right.
'Cause they think if they take a child to McDonald's, everything, oh, I did my job. But it's more than that. It's that father who's there for that child all the time. When they're sick, when they're in need of someone to confide in, and especially with female children, a relationship with a father and daughter relationship is very important, because if they don't establish that when they're young, these girls go out here and they look for love in the wrong places, because the first relationship a child has, or a young lady has, is with her father.
That's my boy.
The definition of a father, it's pretty much your father in heaven is first.
That's him.
I was given to you by the Heavenly Father. So I understand those things and those principles, and it brought me back to you. You know, you didn't live in a house with us. You didn't stay in a house with you, but at the same time, you showed everyone in that house love and affection after not getting it from your father. And this is what I want to share with the America, is that it doesn't matter if the father is not present.
It does.
You understand that? You know,
it really does.
Exactly.
It's a thing. It's amazing. You see, first of all, I said, you just said a point. You close to me, I stand, I think you got 18. And you know more about 18. You know more your mother. After 18, your whole soul is bound by to God.
You loved me through my pain. You loved me through my pain. You loved me through my good. You loved me through my bad, Jesus. You didn't erase my future because of my past. I'm glad you loved me through my good and my bad.
Through my good
and my bad.
There's a lot that we can do as far as the home is concerned, but we can never replace the father. I think we've done a good job of trying to replace dads in some ways. But ultimately, if you look at the way society is and the way things have changed, there are certain things that a woman just can't do. It gets to a point where a boy does need to identify with his own gender. And we can try. And I've seen some very strong women, but in my opinion, we can't replace the father. You're too important. God made you too special.
Oh, thank you.
All right.
Thank you.
You're welcome.
God bless.
So what
he? You loved me through my good. You loved me through my bad. You loved me through my good. Love me through my bad, Jesus. You didn't erase my future because of my past.